Talk presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. They'll knock him down for a loss.
The defense was just all over that play. It didn't fool anybody.
That makes it second and 14.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Makes the catch, and look out, steps out of bounds at the 28.
As long as they're making completions and positive yards when they go to the air, then it can't be too bad of a play.
Caught, open field. He gets hit out of bounds around the 36-yard line. That was a good pass and catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle.
Booming kick. And down he goes at the 26-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Feeds it to the back. Nice run there. He gets 4, maybe 5 yards on the counter. From their own 31-yard line. Second down. Quick throw to the tight end. They'll bring him down at the 40-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Made at the 43-yard line. The option keeper gets him 2, maybe 3 yards.
That'll make it second and 7.
From their own 43-yard line. Second down. On play action. He's looking for 6. And he will score. Tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
And he hits the PAT. So a 4-play, 74-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense looking more and more explosive.
So the score now, 7-0. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Owls are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change the game plan. They give to the tailback. And down he goes at the 24-yard line.
He just timed the snap count there and really made a nice play.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. And he's sacked.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
defense hoping for another sack here on third and long. He sails it long. Tipped away.
Well, the great safeties are almost like a center fielder, roaming back in the back, just reading the quarterback's eyes. Here he does a really good job of seeing where the quarterback wants to go with the football, getting a very good jump on it, and simply not getting it away from the receiver.
He really got a hold of that one. Oh, what a hit. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. That last pass was good for maybe 5 yards.
Not a bad play. They gained 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Short gain there by the halfback for the first down.
Good work by the defense to limit him to a short gain, but he'll still pick up the first down.
He's tackled at about the 41.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Fakes to the back. Gets rid of it quickly. Got him again. First and goal coming up. He's knocked down after a big game. A good looking pass that time.
Well, here they do a nice job of getting the ball out to their speedy receiver. And he shows you that he not only can turn on the jets, but he's got pretty decent hands as well.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They'll work the left. Runs outside for a nice game.
That brings him second and goal.
Brought down around the 5 yard line.
That is just a great play getting into the backfield. This guy is so quick that the ball carrier never had a chance.
This is the 8th play of this drive. Makes it out to about the 5 yard line.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for them.
They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. And if they can connect on this one, that'll put them up by a couple of scores. The kick is up, and the field goal is good. We're through one quarter. The Owls with a 10-point lead. Like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's taken down at the 38.
With the reception.
From their own 38-yard line, First down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Here's a throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens? One away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
It's third down, 8 to go. Ball on their own 40. He might not be able to get the pass off. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
First and 10, ball on the 35-yard line. And he's tackled around the 26-yard line.
Gain of 9 on the play. That brings up second and 1.
Pressure. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
Wide receiver's role in a play-action pass is to get into position and to hit his spot in timing and rhythm with the quarterback. And that's exactly what they were able to do on this last play. You realize you've got a little bit more time because of the play-action, and it gives you more time to get to that point that the quarterback's looking for you to be at. But make sure you do a good job of selling your route and getting in position to give an open target for the quarterback.
Here's the 8th play of the series. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Caught out in the open. And they make the stop at the 3-yard line. This is the 10th play of this drive.
Backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
From the 5-yard line, second down. They'll bring him down around the 4-yard line. Here's the 12th play of the drive. Strike to the receiver. Not a lot on that one.
This junior wide receiver had absolutely no room to run after the catch. Good play by the defense.
Fourth down. This should be an easy field goal, and they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
False start, offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
This one should be makeable. Kicks up, and he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
They line up to kick this one away. He's out to the 30. gets out to about the 31.
And we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this well.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break? Eventually, it could be the team that wins it.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Caught with room to work. Tackle made at the 45-yard line. From their own 45-yard line, it's first down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Quickly incomplete.
Number 86, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and eight.
And this one is a beauty. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
To the tight end, and down he goes
at about the 29-yard line.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense, and in this case he did.
It's on the ground, and who's got it? One of the defensive linemen. Tackle at the 36.
It's not like receivers don't practice hanging onto the ball all week. This is just a case of the defense creating a turnover.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
He gets rid of this one.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 36. Just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They bring him down.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long.
This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position in this football game. Low scoring first half of play, but a close game. 10-3, Owls.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Defense has been in total control in the first half, and you'd think maybe the offense's confidence was shaken. But if you want to look at the entire team picture, David, how big a deal is it for an offense to know, look, if we can just put together one, maybe two good scoring drives, our defense has got our back?
Well, a lot of times when you know you have a defense, is this great? Build your offense around it. And when I say that, why do I need to take chances? You know, if it's third and long, I don't mind throwing a 5-yard pass, and if I break a tackle, I get a first down. I mean, don't put my defense that's dominant, that's great, in a bad position, and you can afford to be more conservative. You see it every single year. What do we always talk about here at ESPN? We talk about you defense wins championships, and that's how you win ball games, and you see it consistently unfold. So if I'm building an offense, let's just not put my great dominant defense in a bad position.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollock can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. They're set to go for another round. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's going to try and scramble. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
Inside, brought down.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 47-yard line, second down. He fights forward to around midfield. From the 38-yard line, first down.
Hey, number eight's coming. Number eight's Mike.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Up a yard. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Throws it out, and it goes nowhere. And if they can connect on this one, that'll put them up by a couple of scores. Kicks away. And he just drilled it from long range. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff.
Right, everywhere we go and we travel over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread or the pistol and hurry up tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
Nice run up the middle.
That'll make it second and seven.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 32-yard line.
Mike four.
a bullet. Intercepted. He just jumped up and snatched that ball.
Well, there, I don't think the quarterback even saw him. The defender went up into the air and made a great catch.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 33-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
That'll make it second and seven.
Scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
From the 12-yard line, first down. Decent run up the gut.
That's good for 7 yards. That'll make it second and four.
For the end zone. What more can you say? He wasn't giving up on that run until he was in for the score.
And he adds the extra point. A four-play, 35-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The score now, 20-3. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Owls continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Brought down at about the 35. Quick throw.
Number seven on the tackle.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 35. Just throws this one away. It's now third down and long. 13 yards to go for the first down after the sack. Here they come. And that'll bring up a punting situation.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. The Owls have shown here in the third quarter they're not content to just sit on that lead they built the first half.
Well, they did a nice job in the first half, but the adjustments that they made at halftime have allowed them to find some matchups to their advantage, and they've taken full advantage of it.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. He's to the 40. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
He gets another set of downs, and more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. more quarter to play. 20-3, Owl. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Tackled at the 45.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and eight.
It's second and eight. Ball on the 45-yard line. Looking for the corner. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He's taken down at the 21-yard line. First and 10 following that big run. On the delayed handoff.
That'll make it second and four.
Watch 32, watch 32. Here we go, here we go.
Down. The 10 gains his way to the 7-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Defense stacked in tight here. And it pays off. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. A nice 7-play, 70-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. The Owls have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it's set up their offense to be able to score points.
So we're just about ready to return to action. They'll bring him down around the 35-yard line.
Called a gain of 10 yards. That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35. Dumps it out left to the running back, and he's taken down at the 42. A 7-yard pickup on the screenplay.
And I thought this play was going to go for more yards, but the defense did a good job of shutting it down before the halfback could get any further downfield.
Receivers got the first down.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on their own 47. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Zips it to the tight end. Tackle made at the 36-yard line.
Boy, when you can rely on your tight end to move the chains, you got a big-time advantage over any defense.
From the 36-yard line, first down.
Check it out.
quickly, and he's got his man. And they make the stop at the 30.
Number seven brings him down at the 30-yard line. That'll make it second and four.
One away. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel. Almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Tackle at the 30-yard line.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Just over 2 minutes in the game. He's to the 40. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 46. The halfback, and they hit him in the backfield.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down, but when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. On the run by the tailback.
Good stop there by the freshman. You got to be careful with this offensive attack because one missed tackle could mean trouble.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. And they get nice yardage on that run. In the books. The Owls come out on top, 27-3. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.